Hey everybody, my name's Timothy.
And I'm Michelle.
And we're going to teach you how to defeat your giants.
In this series, we're going to learn some big lessons from one of the coolest stories in the Bible, David and Goliath.
The story is found in 1 Samuel chapter 17. The army of Israel had a huge giant to defeat. The giant's name was Goliath.
It's Goliath.
Gesundheit.
Never mind. Goliath was a huge giant. He was over 9 feet tall.
9 feet tall? Are you kidding me?
No, I'm serious.
Man, 9 feet tall? That's like two of me stacked together. Hey, me. How's the weather up there?
Okay, we get it.
For real though, 9 feet tall? That's huge.
It sure is, and this giant was threatening the whole army of Israel.
Man, Israel sure had a giant problem.
They sure did.
Kids, have you ever had a giant problem? You know, a problem that's way bigger than you and you felt totally helpless?
Well, a good friend of ours definitely has a giant problem. His name is Evan.
Evan is a really nice kid who has lots of friends, but he has one giant problem. His problem has a name too, Rusty.
Rusty is the school bully. He messes with Evan every day at the playground. No matter what Evan tries to do to avoid him, he's always there to pick on him.
The other day, Evan and his friends were on the playground. Rusty came over and threw his ball all the way across the field. How mean is that? Kids, do you have a giant problem? I don't necessarily mean that you have a bully picking on you at school, but do you have a giant problem standing in your way?
Maybe the giant in your life isn't a bully. It could be problems in your family, loneliness, sadness, or even worry. It might even be a sin in your life, like stealing, talking about people behind their back, and lying.
Lots of kids have giant problems in their life that seem to be holding them back from what God truly wants them to be.
In this series, we're going to learn how to defeat our giants, but we can't do it alone. We need God on our side. No matter how big our giant is, our God is bigger.
I know you'll love today's lesson. We're going to meet the giant Goliath and learn some important truths that we all need to remember about giants.
Until next time, I'm Michelle.
And I'm Timothy.
And we'll see you later on Giants.
Over waves can be hard to do. constant, my hope exhausted. You will be my strength. When my mind says I'm not good enough, God, you're enough for me. Yeah, I've decided I'm not giving up. 'Cause you won't give up on me. You won't give up on me. Your love is holding on and it won't let go. I feel it breaking out like an echo.
Hello, Kate Kids. Welcome to another week of Digital Church. I am excited that you tune in this morning on your big screen TV or your tablets or cell phones. I'm curious, actually. Let's take a poll here. Raise your hand if you are watching me in your living room right now. Raise your hand. Oh, wow. Okay. Nice. Let's see. Raise your hand if you're watching me from your kitchen. Yeah? Eating breakfast while getting your church in? I like that. Let's see, where else? Raise your hand if you're watching me from your bedroom. Yeah, laying in your bed, I like it. Very cool. Let's see, where else could you be watching this from? Oh no, no. Please don't tell me. Please don't tell me you're watching me in your bed. Because that would be gross. All right, we're getting off topic here, but it doesn't matter. So this week we are continuing on our sermon series called Giant. Last week, what did we talk about? Well, we introduced a brand new character in our Bible story. We are learning from one of the coolest stories in the Bible. We are learning from the story of David and Goliath. And last week, we introduced Goliath. You remember him? That 9-foot-tall giant. And we talked about how giants in our lives aren't meant to be ran from. We shouldn't be running and hiding from our giants. But in fact, giants are meant to be taken on head first. Giant problems are meant to be defeated with God's help. And that brings us to week number 2. The title of our message today is, Who's Going to Fight This Giant? You see, this week we are going to introduce a brand new character in this story. It's going to be a character that I think all of you guys are going to like. So you're going to want to stay tuned to this week. We're going to learn all about how, no matter how old you are, no matter how young you think you are never too young to do big things for God. So you are going to want to stay tuned. Today's going to be a great day. But before I say anything else, I need you guys to tune in. My best friend is coming on next. Skittles, he is in the house, and he's going to tell us what's up. We'll see you guys real soon. What's up? What's up?
Ah, yeah, what's up, peeps? It's me, the SKI to the double TLES, Skittles in the Hizzy, and I'm ready to tell you what's up. Today, we're talking about how we are never too young to defeat the giant problems in our lives. So every time somebody asks you, what's up, you tell them, I'm not too young to take on the giant. You ever had somebody tell you that you're just a kid? Doesn't that just make you mad?
Sorry, you can't ride this roller coaster. You're too young. You can't play in this game. You're too young. You can't own a pet rhinoceros. You're too young. And they weigh like 2,000 pounds.
There are some things in life that you're just too young for, but you are never too young to take on the giant in your life. God's help, you can defeat that giant and show it who's boss. So anytime, I mean anytime, somebody asks you, what's up? You tell them, I'm not too young to take on the giant. And that's what's up. I got a rainbow of flavor, and I'm living for my savior. Skittles out, baby.
Totally.
Jack John, how are you doing today?
Howdy do. How you doing?
Well, that's a big axe you have there.
Well, when you got big trees in this forest, you better be ready to have a big axe.
Haven't you heard of a chainsaw?
Well, you know, this fine piece of equipment here, I don't need them shiny things from the city.
From the city, huh? Now, how long have you been cutting down trees, would you say?
You know, since the age of one or two.
One or two?
Yeah.
That's crazy!
Pretty wild, if you ask me. Yeah, the one piece of advice if I had to do anything is, if you got God, nothing is impossible.
Nothing is impossible if you have God. That's pretty awesome. Man, that makes me want to just go down and chop down a million trees.
Well, you know what? I've got your first task for you. Here you go. Chop down them trees.
Wait, this is really heavy.
What did we just talk about? You can do it. Face your giant.
I can face my giant. I can do this. I'm going to go chop down a tree.
It's right over there to the north, about 10 steps behind, and about two squirrels left.
All right. See you later.
Well, I'm gonna tell you folks, there's a lot of things in this woods that can get you, can bite you, can sting you, make you trip up. I'm gonna tell you one thing, you got a God, there ain't nothing you can't do. Alright? Y'all keep chopping down them trees. Don't use them chainsaws. This is Lumberjack John, I'm out.
Well, hello. Long time no see. How are you guys doing? So, it is time for my favorite part of the... Wait a second. Are you sleeping? Hey, wake up. What are you doing? It's time for the Bible story, silly. So everybody, grab your Bibles. We are going to continue on with our story of David and Goliath. Are you ready? Let's do this. Last week, we left off having met Goliath, the giant Philistine who threatened the army of Israel. He wanted one of the Israelites to come out and face him in battle. If they beat him, then the Philistines would be the slaves of Israel forever. But if Goliath won, the Israelites would have to become the slaves of the Philistines forever. Over and over, Goliath came out and screamed to the army of Israel, "Send me a man who will fight me." Each day, the Israelite army stood shaking in their boots with fear. They would never send out anyone to fight Goliath. All of the soldiers were too scared. There was a young shepherd boy named David that lived in Israel. He had several brothers who were fighting in the army. David's dad, Jesse, asked him to take some food out to his brothers. He wanted to let them know that the family back home was thinking about them. So that is exactly what David did. He gathered the food and made the long journey to the battle lines where his brothers had been for some time. When David arrived at the place where the battle was supposed to be taking place, he expected to see all kinds of fighting going on. But that is not what he saw. He saw the entire army of Israel hiding while the giant, Goliath, screamed and yelled insults at them. David even heard Goliath say all kinds of curses about the Almighty God. David was very shocked and surprised by this. Not only was he shocked by all the terrible things that Goliath was saying about God and God's people, but he was amazed that no one was doing anything about it. The entire army of Israel was allowing this big giant to talk like this about God and threaten his people. David began to ask the soldiers around him, "Is there no one who will stand up to this giant Philistine?" The soldiers told him that everyone was afraid to fight Goliath. Here they were, grown soldiers trained to fight, but no one wanted to fight Goliath. David spoke up and said, "I will fight this giant." He was just a young shepherd boy, but he knew he was not too young to take on this giant. In your lesson today, you're going to learn how you can do the same thing as David. You are never too young to take on the giant problems in your life. And with God's help, you can defeat them.
Hey, kids, wasn't that an amazing Bible story? Well, now it's time for the Power Verse. Let's tune in to Tiny Tanya to see what she has to say today.
Hi everyone, I'm Tanya, but most people call me Tiny Tanya because I'm pretty tiny. Okay, I'm really tiny. Most of the things that are normal size to other people are ginormous to me. Well, I've got a huge list of things to get from the warehouse I work at and ship to the customers of Amazon.com. But before I do, I'm going to teach you today's Power Verse. Today's Power Verse says, "Don't let anyone think less of you because you are young. Be an example to all believers." 1 Timothy 4:12. That Power Verse was massively awesome. Now I want all the girls to stand up and say the Power Verse with me on the count of three. 1, 2, 3. Don't let anyone think less of you because you are young. Be an example to all believers. 1 Timothy 4:12. Great job, girls. You can have a seat. But now I want all the boys to stand up to their feet and say the Power Verse with me, Tiny Tanya, on the count of three. 1, 2, 3. Don't let anyone think less of you because you are young. Be an example to all believers. 1 Timothy 4:12. Great job, boys. You can have a seat now. I'm so glad that we have this Power Verse today. I have to ship this giant Coke bottle to a man named Trey Mendes. And earlier, when I was carrying it around, some of the people I work with at the warehouse were making fun of me. They were calling it a baby bottle because I was so young. They said I would never be able to ship something this big. But I know that I have to be a great example, no matter how young or small I am. With God's help, I can do this. Now it's time for everybody to stand up and say the Power Verse with me on the count of three. 1, 2, 3. Don't let anyone think less of you because you are young. Be an example to all believers. 1 Timothy 4:12. That was great, but I better get going because if these items don't get shipped, the customers won't get their purchases in time. I better scram. I mean, bam! I'll see you later, boys and girls. This is Tiny Tanya. Bye-bye.
Hey guys, my name is Matthew. My favorite food is pizza. Wait, that's not what we're supposed to be learning. We're supposed to be learning about the power person. I mean the boys to stand out as loud as you can. 1, 2, 3.
Don't let anyone think less of you because you are young. Be an example to all believers. 1 Timothy 4:9-12.
Boys, that was very good, but the girls are going to do it more better. I am counting 1, 2, 3.
Don't let anyone think less of you because you are young. Be an example to all believers. 1 Timothy 4:9-12.
Boys and girls, that was great, but dogs can do it better. On the count of three, do it in your best dog voice. 1, 2, 3.
Oh yeah, I am so excited. Hey. Where's everybody? I can't wait to shoot this power verse. Miss Melissa, I'm ready to shoot the power verse.
Oh, we have it done already. It's good.
You have it done already? What are you talking about? Who shot the power verse? What's going on?
Disney or the Bible? In the beginning, there was only ocean. Who said that? Disney or the Bible? Disney. Only the act of true love will thaw a frozen heart. Disney or the Bible? Disney, Olaf! Love your enemies. The Bible or Disney? Said the Bible, that's right. There is a time for everything and a season for every activity. Disney or the Bible? The Bible! Why do you look for the living among the dead? Disney or the Bible? The Bible! Remember who you are. You are my son and the one true king. Ooh, this one's kind of tricky. Disney or the Bible? Disney! Quick, let me have some of that red stuff. I'm starving. Disney or the Bible? The Bible. You don't have time to be timid. You must be bold, daring. Disney or the Bible? Disney! The truth needs to be found, otherwise there is no future. The Bible or Disney. Disney! The flower that blooms in adversity is the most rare and beautiful of all. Disney or the Bible? Disney!
Today's Bible story was about a young hero in the Bible named David! That's right! And David was a young boy who realized that he needed to step up and defeat the giant. Now, he was young, he wasn't prepared, but he knew that he had to do it. Now, he could have come up with a million excuses, like saying, I'm too young, or I'm too little, or I'm not ready, I've never been in war. But he knew that he could do it with somebody's help. Who do you think that could be? God's help, that's right. He knew he could do it with God's help. But not only that, he also realized that you're never too young to take on your own giants. You see, David understood that he couldn't wait for the other soldiers to be ready to go defeat the giant. They were too scared. They couldn't do it. So he realized he had to do it himself. But he had to do it with God's help. Some of us, we have some giants that we can really get rid of. Like maybe, for example, we have a giant bad attitude. Or we are really bad liars. Or we're really mean to our brothers and our sisters. Or we're really sad and unhappy. And you know, those are all things that some kids would look at and be like, I'll worry about it when I'm older. Or no big deal, I'm just a kid. This is what I'm supposed to do. I'm supposed to have a bad attitude. I'm supposed to be mean to those people around me. I'm supposed to lie, I'm just a kid. No big deal, I can worry about that when I get older. But you know what? Doesn't matter how old you are, God wants to help you get rid of those giants in your life. And you can do it with God's help. Remember what we learned last week, if you don't take care of your giants now, they can get worse later. I mean, I'm talking about your attitude could get 10 times worse, which can get you in even more trouble. Or maybe being mean to that friend, maybe you won't ever have them again in your life. Things can get even worse if you don't deal with them right now. And guess what? You're never too young to deal with your giants. And you can take care of your giants because it's not how old you are, it's how much God is in you. The reason that you can face your giant today is not because of how big you are, how young you are, how old you are, how strong you are. It's because the power of God lives in you. That's right. He lives in you. And he is there for you and he wants to help you through all of your problems in life. He wants to make sure that you have good godly friendships. He wants to make sure that you have a good attitude. He wants to make sure that you love your brothers and your sisters. He wants to make sure that you don't lie. He wants to make sure that if you're sad, that you have his joy. And you know what? You can do that because God lives inside of you. And you can face all of your problems with God. Now, David knew that he could face the giant with God's help. I mean, everybody around him knew that there was no way that this little boy was going to defeat this big old giant. But what they didn't know is that David had the power of God inside of him. And because of that, he was able to defeat the giant. That means today, no matter what problem you're facing, no matter what situation you're facing, you can take care of it and you can defeat it because God is with you. So we don't have to wait for tomorrow or 10 years from now to fix something. We can do it today, because today is the day. I know we're all at home, and we all maybe all miss our friends. We're all tired and lonely, and sometimes maybe get a little upset. And we're probably wondering, when is this all gonna be over? Well, this is one giant in all of our lives that we can say, God, we need your help. And guess what? With God's help, we can get through this. So we're just gonna pray. So if you guys just bow your heads and close your eyes, we're gonna pray. God, we thank you for today. God, we thank you that you are with us, that you love us, and that your power helps us overcome all of the giants in our life. God, we pray for those giants, that you would help us overcome them, Lord. God, we love you, and we pray for your safety and your health, and that you would just keep us all protected. In your name we pray, amen. We love you guys, and we can't wait to see you really soon. But for now, this is all for Keep Kids at Home.